I've withheld this for about 2 years because in the end, this is definitely a personal video, but I came to terms with the fact that this personal video was actually public domain and now millions of people have seen it. So I felt like it was in my right to actually finally speak about it. Because it's no longer personal. I'm making this video not just because it's going to be cathartic for me, because it definitely will be, but I realize the implications and how it can actually integrate into your life too. In terms about Jubilee or in terms about Stephanie, this video will glance over a few things of those things, but this really is a video about the reception that came forth. Because if millions of people have seen this video and they reacted in the way that they did, that means we interact with each other as a society in a way that I feel like is very, very troubling. I feel like there's a lot of skewed perception when it comes to me and her and Jubilee or whatever else, and I think that's exactly what I want to speak about. In terms of Jubilee as a video channel, I have no problems with them whatsoever. I don't think they skewed the video to paint me in a particular way. I don't think they had an agenda. They just needed to fit 1 hour of footage of deep, intense stuff to fit into 10 minutes and make it worthwhile and make it, you know, accessible enough for everyone to watch. So in the way that the videos were cut together, I do not blame them in one way or another at all. I do think that the way that the video was actually cut, it led a lot of people to believe a particular way, but it's not Jubilee's fault. It's the person's watching's worldview and perspective being projected onto me and the video itself. The reactions from the commenters and the video itself was entirely split. I mean, let's just throw it out there. 70% of the video is just like, oh, look, another edgy lesbian. I thought it was a girl. I thought it was a lesbian. I thought it was a woman. Okay. Get over that. Cool. I look like a girl. Awesome. But let's move past that. The other half of the comments were about how sexy I am or how amazing I am. And also a lot of people were able to relate to issues that I was speaking into the video when it comes to feeling rejected all the time, going through depression and feeling hopeless and all of those things, which was actually the most important thing for me to see. The fact that so many people can relate to me when it comes to those things. And the other half, I would say 75% of the video was completely siding on her side and talking about how I am a manipulative, narcissistic, fuckboy, heartbreaker type of personality. And I've held this in for 2 years and I barely even acknowledged this aspect of the entire video for 2 years. The only thing I did was make a parody of a video basically embodying what people were projecting onto me. I played a character of the most egomaniacal fuckboy that did not care about people or feelings at all whatsoever, just because I wanted to make a statement of what people wanted me to be. Other than that, I haven't spoke about the video, about Stephanie, and about the relationship whatsoever because I needed to take responsibility for my own personal involvement in the situation, and I didn't want to be the person to slander her openly and have change everybody's perspective on her. And with that being said, I just really want to throw this out there. The fact that if this video were to come out again and the roles were switched where I was in Stephanie's position and Stephanie was in my position, let's actually take this a step further. If the guy was twice the age of the girl in the video and the guy claimed, hey, you're my girlfriend and you don't even know it, imagine the backlash and the reaction that would come from that. Go ahead, think about it. I don't know what you are personally thinking about right now, but I think, in my opinion, that it would definitely be a scandal. I think that statement right there in a viral video would be big enough to circulate all over digital media. The fact that a guy twice the age of a girl just said, hey, look, you're my girlfriend. You don't know it yet, you're my girlfriend. And if the girl was like, you know what? I don't think that that's okay. I think that I just want to see what's going on. I think we're just having fun and that's fine. Everybody would side with the girl and everybody would paint the man that's twice her age in a manner where he is a disgusting individual. However, in my situation, when she claimed that I am her boyfriend without my consent, then I'm the asshole for not listening and giving her exactly what she wanted. And I thought that was a very interesting situation. Like, why is it that this is okay, but not this? I told her from the very beginning that that wasn't what I was looking for multiple times. Keep in mind, this relationship, which wasn't even a relationship in the first place, lasted 2 to 3 months. I think that's just enough time to kind of feel out who a person really is. If that's the amount of time you need to take to immediately jump into the relationship, I'm sorry, I completely disagree. I've done it before and it doesn't end up well, which was why I was being extra careful and didn't want to just join in a relationship and become someone's boyfriend when I explicitly stated and I knew that I really just was not ready to be involved in somebody like that. And from all of the reception and seeing what happened in the videos that are out now and seeing the commenters, I realized that people generally only listen to emotions. As opposed to rationale and logic and objectivity, people reacted to emotions. I was straightforward and I was logical as I possibly could in the video, but she was very emotionally vulnerable, which is why I think that a lot of people decided to side with her. For some reason, in the reaction video, the last 5 seconds of me is me taking off my headphones and being emotionally vulnerable and silent for about 5 seconds. This 5 seconds is the most time-stamped and commented part of the entire video. It was almost as if everything that I said during that entire 9-minute video beforehand was completely overlooked. But instead, everyone decided to comment on one tiny snippet of me not saying anything where I was emotionally vulnerable. Why is all of a sudden everybody happy and satisfied and all of a sudden can relate to me because I'm sad? It doesn't make any sense to me. It's unfair for me. The fact that I can still logically and rationally state my situation and perspective on the entire thing logically as I possibly can and none of that gets taken in and instead I'm shamed and to be claimed that I'm a fuckboy, but the moment I actually show 2 seconds of feeling all of a sudden, it's valid. And I think that's a huge problem because if we just all view things and validate people for their emotions, that means I can justify any fight that I can get into. If somebody hurts somebody and they decide to wreck their car or burn down their house or something to that extreme, it's justified because somebody got hurt emotionally. If we just all reacted purely emotionally to things, then we'll have a shit show on earth. And if you take that to the furthest extent, really, it can fuck everything up. I honestly think that everybody or a lot of people decided to side with her in that situation is because she was so emotionally vulnerable. Not saying that she was wrong, but they disregarded what anything that I had to say because I decided to withhold and internalize my emotions a bit more. Why wasn't my position respected in any way? I thought consent was a huge thing in today's culture. Consent is probably one of the most important things nowadays. However, when I don't give somebody's consent, when I don't give her consent, then I'm an asshole for not allowing that to happen. However, if we switch the roles and a man decided to tell a woman, "You're my girlfriend," and she doesn't give consent, imagine what would happen. All of a sudden, I'm an asshole, a narcissist, a fuckboy, for standing my ground, re-implying my boundaries multiple times. And I'm the person that's the asshole in the situation. And a lot of people wanna know, was I hurt at the end of the video? Of course I was fucking hurt. Is that what would make everybody happy? To know how hurt I am as an individual and how sad at this entire situation I am? Do you think I wanted to break somebody's heart? Do you think I wanna hurt anybody in my life? Do you want me to express myself and externalize my inner volatility and the hopelessness and the depression that I've experienced in my life in order to be heard? It's ridiculous. I've been through so much. And the fact that when I try to be level-headed and I try to be rational about my emotions and feelings, that they get taken and misconstrued as something that I disagree with. Absolutely. Yes. I was hurt. That was an emotionally volatile relationship that I had a lot of issues with and brought up a lot of deeper traumas within my life. And it hurt me a lot. And when that video ended, I had to live through everything once again. And on top of that, deal with everybody thinking the fact that I'm still a manipulative, narcissistic, emotionally heartless individual. And when it comes to emotions and feelings, I'm very private about that because I don't believe that somebody else should deal with my own inner issues unless it was a therapist or something like that. So I put all of my problems into my music and art. I have an EP coming out, and if you really want to know how I'm feeling, listen to the music. I don't think it's fair to just give somebody all of your emotions all the time, especially the negative ones. I'll give all my positive emotions to as many people as I possibly can. But when it comes to negativity, I don't think that's a type of energy that other people deserve to handle, especially if it's me giving them the burden of doing so. Let's just say, for example, in the video, if I were to react emotionally, then I wouldn't be forgiven. If I were to react and just say, you know what? I do care, but da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. They would be like, oh my God, he's getting way too emotional about the situation. Like, he needs to get his shit together. He needs to stop freaking out so much. So if I am emotional, I am an unstable, childish, immature man-child. However, if I try to be stoic and logical and objective as I can, I am a manipulative, narcissistic fuckboy asshole. I think in today's world, we like to think that things are equal with all of the race, all of the gender, all the cultural backgrounds, and whatever else you want to say, and here's the honest truth, it isn't. It's not. There's double standards to everything. No matter what your background is, it doesn't have to be man or woman or whatever else. It's not equal. Nothing is equal. We're all different, but that doesn't mean it's bad. Our differences should be appreciated and we should learn how to work with them. But in terms about leveling the playing field where everybody's in the same exact position, it's impossible because what I experienced from the reception of this video, I guarantee, flip the roles around and rewatch the entire video and we'll see what you think about that. In terms of the relationship, I was honest from day one or two because during the first meeting, you don't want to talk about relationships. But of course, we were moving really fast. So during the second time that me and her met up, I told her, look, I'm not looking for anything serious. I'm not looking for a relationship. I don't want commitment right now because I'm in a very dark place and I don't exactly think I can handle a relationship. And I told her on day two, and also keep in mind, we were meeting up once or twice a week for 2 to 3 months. Imagine seeing somebody only once a week for 2 months. How close can you actually get? I was not ready for a relationship at all. And when I told her that, she kept pushing and pushing and pushing as if my consent didn't matter at all. And to see so many people side with her in that situation makes me think, wow, it's a good amount of the population that agrees with this form of thinking that I disagree with. I don't think it's fair. We should respect each other's boundaries and consent, and I thought everybody was on the same page with this, but apparently not. When it comes to the actual video and what was being said during the video, they asked, do you love her? And I said, damn, I do in a particular way because da 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 da. And a lot of people were mad at the fact that I didn't just answer a yes or no question. What I did was I tried to be courteous and polite during this video that was being shot with overhead lights and 3 video cameras and 10 people on set. What do you want me to do? Say no to her face right there? It's called being polite and courteous. Let's take, for example, if I did what people wanted me to do and they asked, do you love her? And I said, no, I don't. How would people view me then? Really? The same way. I'm an asshole if I say courteously and politely as I can in a way where, look, I don't love you, however I do in a certain way. And those people want me to just say no. And if I said no, they would be, okay, you're also an asshole. So no matter what answer I would have said, I still would have been painted the same negative way. In terms of the relationship itself, regardless of the videos that came out, it was the birth and the beginning of a toxic dynamic, 100%, because I have been in many toxic relationships where I've been pushed around and manipulated, and I've been toxic in other relationships as well, and I could totally see that within these 2 months, there are 10 red flags already. My life at the time was in a situation that I definitely could have not been romantically involved with somebody. It was the most depressive time in my life. life. I was so lost. I had no money. I was working two jobs in retail, in a mall. My art and my music, my career was not going anywhere. No, I had no friends. My only friends at the time was my therapist that I saw once a week. We only saw each other for 2 months, one or twice a week, while I was working two jobs at the time. And you're like, Pierre, then why did you meet up with her if you were in a dark place and you knew you couldn't handle it romantically? Because that wasn't my intention from the beginning. What am I supposed to do? Because I'm in a dark place and I have to do all this stuff, I still have to isolate myself and I can't meet any new acquaintances, new friends, new people. I still can't do that. I'm not supposed to see anybody. My intention with meeting her wasn't exactly to even involve myself romantically. And I told her that from the very beginning. It was toxic during the entire time. We were fighting and screaming at each other because I was trying to implicate my boundaries from the very beginning. And every time the subject came up, let's be boyfriend and girlfriend. No, I'm not ready. Come on. You need to be my boyfriend because we just see each other all. I don't think so because I'm not ready for it. And I had to explain why. I said that being a boyfriend and a girlfriend in a relationship means that there are responsibilities and expectations for each other. That's what a relationship is. You hold each other up and you support each other and you lift each other up in times of darkness and whatever else. However, I knew I was not ready because I could barely take care of myself at the time, let alone take care of somebody else. Her opinion was, no, we don't have to have responsibilities or expectations. We just hang out a lot and that means we can be boyfriend and girlfriend. And I said, no, the moment we become an official relationship, we both have spoken and unspoken responsibilities and expectations for each other. And if you think a relationship doesn't need that, then that means it's not going to be a strong relationship. I came home drained every single time we fought and every time I was there, which is why we only saw each other once or twice a week. Not only did I have to deal with a narcissistic boss working two jobs simultaneously in rush hour traffic in Los Angeles, I had to go and fight with somebody that I wasn't even a relationship with in the first place. After 2 to 3 months, I told her, look, you're a great person and you do have really good intentions. However, I'm coming home drained every day and I'm working two jobs and it's really exhausting and I really have a lot of trouble in my life right now and I don't think that this will work out. And obviously she did not take no for an answer and she was really pissed and really angry with me and really tried to push the fact that we can just hang out and whatever else. But I already had so much going on in my life that I really could not deal with another element of expectations and forceful responsibility for something that I knew in my heart that I was not ready for at the time. So then I left the relationship and then the video came out. So then everything had to be brought up again. We broke up and all the comments and all of our social media platforms blew up again and we weren't already seeing each other from there. She did not take it very well. I tried to look at the positive side of the situation. I've been through enough hurt and pain to completely focus on that. So I looked at every positive element of the video coming out and I ignored the negativity, which also in return made me seem like an asshole because it seemed like I didn't care. She tried contacting me a few times, but I said no. I would message her, you know, just to acknowledge her and in any way that I can, like just, you know, hello, I hope everything's okay, stuff like that. But she wanted that emotional intensity out of me. So she kept trying to call me and eventually she called me and talked to me about the video and she was not taking it well. And I tried helping her and anyway, you know what? The video, it came out and you know, I'm sorry that you're going through all of this. It's very intense. This is very new and it's really awful the fact that this came out after we broke up and you know, I tried to talk her through the situation as logically and rationally, but that's not what she wanted. She wanted emotional volatility from me. So she just eventually got to a point where she started blaming me for the video being made. You know, she's like, I can't believe I did this. Why did I do this video with you? Like, and started screaming at me on the phone, which in return made me scream at her because it's not my fault. I think that you are an adult just as much as I am. In fact, you're twice my age and I think you should be able to be mature enough to handle the responsibility that you took for your own actions. I'm doing that right now and I think you should. Why are you screaming at me? I told her, you know what? The last time we spoke, I was totally fine with where we were in the relationship and we ended up okay. But now, after you yelling at me, after when the situation's supposed to be over, I don't want to see you again. And that was it. It was done. I could not be in contact with her anymore because now in my mind, anytime that she wanted to talk to me in any way, she's looking to get an emotional reaction out of me. So why would I open up the dialogue again if I knew or I felt like every time she wanted to talk to me, she was gonna make me angry? I didn't speak about the video or relationship practically at all during the last 2 years because I will take responsibility for my own actions and what I want to say and what I need to say. And if I fuck up, then I fuck it up for myself. If I were to bring her in to my personal opinions and perspectives, it could skew everybody's perspective of her, which is unfair for her. So I didn't even talk about it. I didn't even want to say it. But of course, I'm an asshole because I didn't even want to acknowledge her. But if I did talk about her, then I'd still be an asshole. There's another thing that people kept saying, and that's like, this guy doesn't really know what he wants. He overcomplicates everything. He's overly philosophical. Love is actually simple. You just need to figure out somebody that you can sacrifice your own time and energy and just let go. Love is like when you really let it go and just give everything you can to somebody else. Guess what? I've done that many times my whole life. I've done it with even friends, romantic relationships, and even my family. I used to try to get my family together to play board games with me because I was neglected as a child, and this happened later in my life too. I tried giving all of my time and energy teaching my friends how to make music and talking to their problems and being there when they're having mental breakdowns at 3 a.m. I've had in relationships where my ex, after a crazy car accident, I would stay with her in the hospital 7 days a week fixing her catheter. I would be giving so much time and energy to these people. And of course, when you give that much, sometimes you just don't get it back. If anything, they could take all that energy and give you negative energy back. I've tried so hard to sacrifice so much of myself and people in my past. I've had best friends that robbed me, even though I gave them free skateboards already and traveled to Las Vegas and paid for their food and dinners and whatever else, and they robbed me, literally broke into my house. It's absolutely absurd. Love is simple, just give out everything you possibly can and then it'll come back to you, no problems. Life isn't like that. We're all emotionally infantile people on this earth that doesn't have any self-awareness in terms of dealing with our inner emotions, and I'm definitely one of those people too. But of course, to live life without love or even chancing the fact that you can actually maybe fall in love again, I decided, you know what, this was hard and I've been heartbroken and betrayed and lived through deception so many times, but I cannot live my life without trying to love somebody again. So then I met somebody months after the video came out, and we got along. We were talking on the phone all the time, and we ended up really liking each other. And we started hanging out. And of course, I thought, you know what? This might be the one. Gave it all. Introduced her to dinner with flowers on the table, you know, cheese and wine and everything else, music playing in the background, all that cheesy shit. And guess what? Emotionally manipulated. I got emotionally manipulated, triggered so many goddamn things that I've already experienced in the past. Just wanted to piss me off all the time. And then, after all that, got kicked out of the flat that I was living in. And as much as I want to blame everyone else for the toxic, painful relationships that I've gone through in my life, it's not all their fault. Half of it is my fault, because there's something unresolved within me that keeps bringing these people into my life and allowing them to manipulate me. There's something that's really deeply missing, a void that can't be satiated within me, which I even said in the video as well. But sometimes people just want to pick and choose what they want to hear. This is not a romantic situation to be in. I'm hurt. I'm in a lot of pain. I've gone through so much shit. I've gone through so much. And I hide it all because I want to be strong for everybody else. Because I want to uplift and motivate everyone else. And I'm willing to hide that pain because I don't want anyone else to go through what I've gone through in the past. I've done so many good things for people. I've motivated people to lose half of their weight. I've taught instruments to people. I've taught my friends how to solve Rubik's Cubes. I've bought dinners for so many people. I've given free shit to so many people. And guess what? I don't talk about it because that's what I was raised to do. When you do good things, you're not supposed to talk about it. You know what? I am gonna talk about it because I'm an asshole if I don't talk about the good things that I do. People will just only see the fact that I'm non-emotional. I internalize everything. All the emotions, I internalize. I bury it within me because I don't think anybody else should carry the burden of my own inner pain. I put it in music. I put it in art. I put it in videos. But yet at the same time, I try to be objective and as level-headed as I possibly can. But it doesn't mean that I'm not emotional. When people actually want to know what's happening with me, I'll refuse to tell them and keep things positive. And they'll keep pushing and 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 keep pushing. And then I go, okay, this is what happened. And I tell them everything. And then it's disregarded. It's not validated. It's downplayed, or it's just too much for them to even handle. I remember when I was with my girlfriend at the time, I told her about how I couldn't get a job because I was discriminated against for how I look. And I had the evidence to prove it. And she fell asleep during my 15-minute rant about it. And she kept trying to get me to talk to her about it. And I did. She fell asleep. So why the fuck would I ever do that again? My feelings and problems obviously don't matter to anybody around me. So obviously, I'm going to keep it within myself where it does actually matter. And this isn't the first time it's happened. It's happened in so many relationships in the past where I'll take in everybody else's problems. In fact, I'm actually more of a listener. I listen to everybody's things. Give me, give me, give me. The moment I say anything, disregarded, downplayed. It's almost as if everybody in these people get a sense of satisfaction from seeing me hurt. Why is it that the timestamp at the end of that video where I'm actually emotionally vulnerably hurt is the timestamp that everybody loves? It's like people get this catharsis from seeing me hurt. Yeah, I'm hurt. I'm hurt. I'm very hurt. And I hope everyone's happy to know that. Do I have to be emotionally troubled to be listened to? It's almost as if people don't even care unless I actually get angry or hurt about something. And that's fucked up. I don't wanna be hurt every single time in order to be listened to. I'm shamed for being level-headed and objective, for being too non-emotional. And then I'm shamed for also being way too emotional about things. I'm sure there are people watching right now. They're like, Pierre, you can just write this all in your diary. You don't have to say this on social media. You need to relax. You just breathe. I'm shamed for expressing myself, and I'm shamed for not expressing myself. And in terms of a diary, social media is my diary. It's my way of expressing myself in a non-filtered way. In fact, it's probably even better that my diary is out there for everybody to see, because we hide so much of ourselves from day-to-day life, especially on social media. There's so much fakery and commercials and all this fucking bullshit on social media where we try to paint the perfect picture of what a relationship is, perfect food, skinny tea, perfect bodies, all this shit. And when it comes to raw truth that can be very painful, we hide it all. And that's why I'm doing what I'm doing, is because I think this needs to be out on the internet for everyone else that feels the same way, that never felt related to or understood in one way or another. All of the comments seemed to be coming from a place of PIERRE projection. It was almost as if I was this archetypal symbol of a fuckboy that hurt everybody in the comments once before. All these people commenting probably had a boyfriend or somebody that broke their heart at one point, and I just embodied all of the elements of that person in their own personal life. But I'm still a person. I'm not just a symbol of what you think is a fuckboy. And that's projecting onto me because I just fit the profile of how I look, how I behave, the fact that I stood my ground, I have boundaries, and I know what I want. Let's just say we live in a society. And in a society, we all wear a mask because we don't want to be vulnerable, and we try to portray our best selves. We put a mask on our face and we behave in a way that other people want us to behave, so we are accepted and validated into the community. Now, in the modern world, especially in their digital age, everybody has their mask glued to their cheeks and they can't take it off. So when they see somebody else walk in with no mask and they speak the authentic, honest truth about something, that person with the mask, all they know is life through a mask. So they think that the honest person is operating with a mask on, meaning the honest person is lying. When everybody lives in a lie, we live in digital social media Hollywood world. Commercials everywhere. Everything is an ad. Everything is marketing. Everything is a persona. Everything's a fucking lie in today's world. When one person is not wearing that mask, they're technically not telling the truth, because the truth is Hollywood already. And if you differ from that, you are not speaking their truth. A lot of people thought the video was scripted. No, You're just used to watching telenovelas, you're used to watching drama, reality shows that are all faked, and that gets projected onto this video. It was 100% real. Both Jubilee videos were unscripted. Real, real, and real. Everything I said in the video was 100% real. Everything. I'm not just some sort of smooth talker trying to manipulate somebody by expressing this emotional turmoil in order to get pity for. All of those things are very, very real. And then to see that everybody looks at that as a lie really says a lot about what's happening in today's world. Why is it that when I personally really do speak from my heart and talk about my problems on a public platform, everyone thinks that I'm lying? It's unfair, it really is, but that's what the world is. It's unfair and I'm learning that. Everybody has been misunderstood at one point. I'm sure you have. Has a rumor ever went around at you in school, in work, in your family? Has some lie ever been spread about you and no one really understands what the hell you're going through, or people just think something about you that isn't even true? Everyone's gone through it. Everyone's gone through it. And it's a terrible feeling. Everything I said in the video was true when it comes to being rejected and used to rejection and feeling hopeless. These are things that I'm not proud about. Listen, I've been rejected and pushed around all my life. I've been rejected, bullied, made fun of, ignored, looked over and condescended every year that I grew up, when it came to even meeting with my family, even meeting with kids at school and even teachers. In terms of relationships, I've been led on for years, multiple times from girls, and I've been cheated on by multiple girls multiple times. I've been robbed by my best friend growing up. I've been physically grabbed and forced out of a church just because I was in the wrong room. I've been in two giant car accidents, and one of them sent my girlfriend at the time into a hospital. She was in a wheelchair for 3 months, and I had to live with that, feeling guilty for it. And then on top of that, during the scene of the accident, my parents left because my dad had a meltdown, and his meltdown was more important than mine when I almost died in the situation. And once that all got wrapped up, my ex's lawyer wanted to sue me and my insurance company afterward for financial gain. It doesn't end. I got into the wrong group of kids at high school. They gave me a bunch of drugs and just used me for my giant house at the time and for me to drive them around. And they were just using me as a punching bag while feeding me drugs at the same time. And once I left that group, they all talked shit on me as well, saying that I was a terrible person, which left me severely isolated and depressed for 2 years straight with no friends and no one to talk to whatsoever. And if you think I'm exaggerating, I'm not. I lived practically alone with no emotional support for 2 full years. I've been kicked out of multiple restaurants and bars and whatever facility that you even want to think about for how I just look. And on top of that, I also couldn't get hired in a particular job or not because of just how I look. And of course, when I got the job, I had a boss that would scream at me for no reason whatsoever on top of that. And still to this day, I still have to deal with judgment and negativity from complete strangers everywhere I go. But I've been a lot stronger about it, and I can handle it a lot better, because nowadays a single negative comment means nothing to me because I have gone through a lot worse in my past. I was raised to be an honest, straightforward person and to stand up for myself against adversity and whatever else. However, by being straightforward and honest in this video and standing up for myself, I'm shamed for doing that as well. If I don't do those things and I'm walked on and people push me around, then I won't be respected. If I stand up for myself and I'm honest, then I won't be respected. So no matter what I did, I'm shamed for what I do and just who I am as a person. And people will find ways to pull out negativity just to shame me for it. I started this entire YouTube channel because I was tired of being fed lies on YouTube, on Instagram, on Facebook, on social media, and just people in general, just people glancing over things, trying to paint a perfect life, trying to fake pictures of their perfect relationships and perfect bodies, perfect travel vlogs and whatever the fuck else, people opening boxes and putting fucking red lipstick on and claiming that they know the secrets to life and this is what happiness is, being fed all this consumerist materialistic nonsense. I started my channel that day because I made a contract with myself saying, If no one is going to do it, I am going to infiltrate the digital landscape and give the most painful, raw, brutal honesty that the internet has not had in a very, very long time. And of course, that will not make everyone happy, and it will make people not like you. But I would much rather be not liked for who I really am than to be liked for who I'm not. I was very bitter and cynical for the longest time after dealing with so much of societal bullshit from everyone around me. I was beat down and I had a very hard time developing hope again. I thought everybody was full of shit, ignorant, naive, but of course, that's not what it really is, because in the end, this is all just first world issues anyways. The video going viral, it wasn't a viral video and everybody's being mean to me, boo-hoo, poor Pierre. I need to put it in perspective, trust me. I make videos on situations that don't necessarily have to deal with living in an overly developed world. I could be starving in an underdeveloped country right now. These things are still put in perspective, but these things also just have just as much validity. Your problems in the first world has a particular weight. But in the end, I had to force myself to focus on the positive elements. When this video came out, a lot more positive came out of it than negative. But of course, by focusing on the positive, you're an asshole because you won't acknowledge the negativity that somebody else is experiencing. But still, I met so many amazing people because of this video going viral. And it's not even just for my self-gain, saying I gained so many followers, I gained a platform. No, the platform is for everyone else. The fact that so many people have been in the same situation in this relationship and have also felt so hopeless and rejected in their lives finally have somebody to relate to, and I finally have somebody to relate to. This entire thing happened and also made me feel less alone in this cruel, harsh world. And just that itself, meeting others that understand your story, can make this existence so much worth living for. Everyone that came into my life after these videos came out gave my life purpose and meaning again. For me to relieve so many others of their own inner suffering, and for them to feel connected to somebody, made me feel connected to somebody, and I had a reason to live again. And I thought I lost that reason a long time ago. After being through all of this fucking shit from so many people that just push me around, that just fucking fuck with me. And for me to be painted as somebody that doesn't give a fuck, I give a fuck too much. I care way too much. That's why I'm making this video, because I do care a lot. Life is really hard. There are so many other things that I didn't even name in this video, but life has a way of throwing another brick at you after the last brick already hit you, and it'll keep going, and it'll keep going, and it'll keep going. But there are also elements of life that's totally worth living for. Life is a spectrum of emotions that you should experience in any form. And as long as you have meaning and purpose in your life, the suffering has a reason to exist. We should be able to appreciate life and not try to go look so hard into other people and telling them how terrible they are. We should maybe take a little more effort into getting to know somebody for who they are instead of judging each other just from the physical appearance and the projections that you have within yourself. Maybe we should reflect on what's actually happening within our own heads and our subconscious before we just claim that we know somebody and know exactly who they are as a person. Because I know everybody watching right now has been misunderstood at one point or another, and I think we should be a little less harsh on ourselves. I think that we deserve a lot better as people, and maybe if we could begin with ourselves, then maybe we could all live in a world where we actually like each other. People will criticize you for whatever, regardless of what you do. If you are a good or bad person, it doesn't matter. People will criticize you in any way whatsoever. So you might as well be hated for who you really are and be happy with yourself instead of being hated for who you're not and not being able to look in the mirror. So with that being said, just be the fuck you and speak your truth. It's PIERRE. Bit then though.